There, this is Andy Graham talking. I'm sorry it's been a late video today. The deadline is in like 30 minutes, but I hope you could watch the video before the deadline. Thursday I was forced to take the shot, COVID-19 shot. As my friends know, I don't believe in this COVID. But for me, it's important to go to the pub after a long day at the docks. So I was forced to take the shot just so I can still be out with the other lads talking and watching ladies, sexy ladies down in Aberdeen. Yes. So I've been having some fever, sub-fever, and I have a headache and my joints are hurting, just like I precautioned. So that's why the, like you can hear, I'm actually really bad. So that's why the episode is a little bit too late. So, we are going through the matches. The first match is Chelsea versus Leicester. You get 172 for a Chelsea victory. Tielemans is out, so that also makes it more clear to play Chelsea this match. Lukaku is still not appeared in team training, but Werner has been involved, the same as Mason Mount. I'm not sure those two players are going to play 90 minutes. May be involved. That means that Havertz still will be playing attacking player. Aston Villa Brighton, Steven Gerrard has come in as a manager for Aston Villa. He says he want to play some more sexy football there. But it's much work to be done, so I think he will start by tightening it up in the back. I think this match will have little goals. You get 1.5 back for playing. No, you get 3 times back for playing under 1.5. That's a pretty good odds. But actually, Aston Villa is the odds favorite, so you can also get 285 back for Brighton victory. I think Tarik Lamptey is one to consider for this match. Still, Trossard is also to consider, and also Sanchez is out, so it's Steele for 4.0 million will be standing in the goal. Burnley Palace. Burnley are the odds favorite, but Palace has been very sexy the last couple of matches. You have Tarik Mitchell are playing on the back. He is cost 4.5 million. So you have Guaita in the goal, 4.5 million. They are two very good picks this round and for the next rounds. And still, you also have Gallagher or Benteke or Saha, who all are good picks for this and the rounds to come. Yeah, not more to say there. Newcastle Brentford, you get 2.6 times back for both Newcastle to win or Brentford. Brentford has a terrific match against Norwich last, but Eddie Howe is also out with COVID. I think you play all your attacking players there. Tony, Mbeumo, Wilson maybe, or Saint-Maximin, I will play them all. So, Norwich Southampton, 2.1 times back for Southampton for victory, 3.3 for home victory Norwich. Impressive last match against Brentford. I think maybe you should play Norwich. New manager Smith, Dean Smith from Aston Villa. I would try Pukki. Put in Pukki now. And also, it's time for Todd Cantwell to play more. Broja, he's been out through the international break. So Adam Armstrong will still play this match as well. He could be putting some goals, but also Pukki. Yeah, we're going to Watford United. 1.5 for United victory. Is it time to get Ronaldo? Maybe. He costs a lot of money, but this is a match I expect that Ronaldo will get some goals. Wolves West Ham. Ogbonna was doing his anterior cruciate ligament the last match. He's out for maybe 9 months. In defense, new player Johnson for 4.0 million is playing on the right back. He's a good differential. West Ham are also odds favorite with 2.35 back. Bowen, you could consider. The same with Antonio. Yes, play him. Liverpool, Arsenal. Robertson are uncertain. That's too bad. That Scottish lad. Oh, but that opens up for Tsimikas again. 3.9 for a Liverpool defender. Whoa, if you're on a wildcard, why not play him? You get 147 back for Liverpool victory. Still, Mane are uncertain. Firmino is out. That means that Jota could be a very sexy pick for now and for the next week. Also, Aubameyang are being assessed today before the match. That's too bad for the Arsenal fans. But Kieran Tierney, also a Scottish lad, he is ready to play again, so it would be very interesting to see if they are choosing Tavares or Tierney. Yes, let's go to Sunday's match, City-Everton. Dominic Calvert-Lewin is still out. Kevin De Bruyne is COVID positive. Foden has a knock. He may be assessed and be playing, but Grealish, he is out. 1.18 for City victory. Whoa! If you are going to do a differential captain pick this week, it could be Cancelo. Okay, last match, Tottenham versus Leeds. 1.7 for home victory. Has Conte got the grip of Tottenham? Son and Kane, too soon? Or is it time to get on the train? That's the big question for this episode. I think that Son, he is definitely worth it to get on, but Kane, he has not looked good. He played and goaled 3 times versus San Marino in the international break, but San Marino, that's not Leeds. And Rafinha now, he's going through a really difficult fixtures. Is it time to jump off him? Maybe. Okay, that was all the matches. We have got some questions in here. We got a question here from Heinrich Schulze. He's asking for some IDs for his wildcard team. So I'm not giving him a wildcard team, but I'm thinking give him some advices and maybe pick out some differential players. We could start in the goal. I would recommend to get Guaita in Crystal Palace. In defense, I'm thinking about Tarek Lamptey and Mitchell from Palace. Maybe Johnson if you are going to be very budget in the defense. And still you have to get players like Arnold and Cancelo and Chilwell or Reece James. Midfield, keep Salah. I will pick players like maybe Jota, time to get Jota and Son. And then it's Mount, Foden, maybe Bernardo Silva since Foden are uncertain for this match. Maybe Gundogan and get maybe Smith Rowe, Gallagher or keep Rafinha. In attack, I think that Antonio is a player to still get. He has a difficult fixtures after Wolverhampton, but there will be a fixture swing in like four matches, and the price he has earned through the season. It's no worth to get rid of him. And that's the difficult question, is the attacker player. Who would you pick? I don't know, actually. Okay, that was a question from Heinrich Schulze. Now there have been some questions from Simon Nielsen. He's American. And he has asked if he should still play Rudiger as captain. I think maybe this week you should switch your captain. Okay. Then there's a question from Monica Milf. She's wondering if I'm single. And yes, I am. I'm single and ready to mingle. Okay. So that was all the questions. I'm saying thank you for now and good luck with this round. Hope you can reach to watch the video.